Droughts can have serious impacts on people's lives, but often the detailed information needed for policy and planning is lacking. Satellites can measure broad surface water changes evident in these computer-generated images showing the water loss in California over just 3 years, with darker reds representing exceptional drought conditions. Drought effects are also seen in lakes and reservoirs, such as Folsom Lake in California, shown here in summer 2011, then photographed 3 years later in winter 2014. Water well levels also offer testimony that our underground water supply is dangerously low. Unfortunately, measuring water stored deep underground in the rocks and soil can be challenging. This animation will show how a network of sensitive GPS instruments can detect changing groundwater and drought severity. Zooming out, lakes and reservoirs lie on top of tectonic plates that maintain a dynamic equilibrium with the asthenosphere. These bodies of water weigh down the surface of the earth, pushing land slightly down when they are full and allowing the land to bounce back up or rebound when water levels are low. Similarly, water in, soil, bedrock cracks, and winter snow pushes the land down. The land then rebounds when the water flows or evaporates away. Sensitive GPS instruments measure this upward motion in the drier summer and downward motion in the wetter winter. Mountains such as California's Sierra Nevada also move slightly down each winter as they are loaded with snow and water, and rise again in the summer as the snow melts and water flows away. We can see these seasonal changes with high-precision GPS records. Over time, we can see the longer-term trends. GPS stations in California show us the mountains have mostly been rising, probably from a combination of tectonic uplift and drying. They were pushed down again in 2011, a particularly wet year, but then rose again even more rapidly during the subsequent drought. The story in the valleys is different. The biggest effect on the height of the land is groundwater withdrawal from pumping. As water is pumped out of aquifers, the sediment under the surface compacts, causing the land to move down or subside. Compaction reduces pore space between the grains, thus the aquifer will have difficulty recharging. This compaction effect is much larger than changes caused by the weight of the water. In valley sites, GPS records show seasonal changes, as farmers and others pump water out of the ground faster in the summer than in the winter. GPS stations in California's Central Valley show a long-term downward trend, as there is more pumping than recharge of groundwater. The subsidence has accelerated starting in 2013 due to drought and increased water use. If we look at one GPS station, color shows vertical movement. Red and orange indicates the ground has moved up, and blue indicates it has moved down. We have a dense network of GPS stations throughout the western United States that allows us to measure the effects of drought across an entire region. Most of the stations in this network are from the EarthScope Plate Boundary Observatory. Researchers estimate that in California during the drought from 2012 to 2015, the equivalent of nearly a year of normal rainfall has been lost. The reds and oranges indicate loss of surface water and groundwater. Although there are still seasonal variations, over the last few years the trend has been ongoing drying. The exception comes in agricultural valleys, which are moving down due to compaction after groundwater withdrawal, shown in blue. This information can help water managers and policymakers plan future use of water resources.